Hello student, in this video today I'm going to explain you about the importance of relationship and your role in it. In my previous video I have already explained you about the families. I have provided already part one, families part one video and family part two video, in which I have explained you about the textual content, whatever in your books I have explained that. This is the third video on families. In this I am going to explain you the importance of relationship and your role in it. So pay attention, watch my video from beginning to end. Happy digital learning. So we are going to do in this video the importance of relationship and your roles in it. Okay, now let's move ahead. In this, the key concept in this video is identify the qualities that help build healthy relationship. Then you have to explain how rewards and cost affect relationship. Then you have to suggest ways to improve your relationship. So these are the things which we are going to do in this video. Now, about the importance of relationship, and we are going to discuss about the main idea that people have many qualities that build and improve a healthy relationship. People have many qualities that help build and improve relationship, a healthy relationship. How we are going to make healthy relationship, I am going to explain you that here. First of all, some of the important vocabulary I want to discuss with you. See here, these are the vocabulary which we are going to cover in this video today. That is relationship. You will come to know what is relationship. Acquaintance, mutuality, trust, self-disclosure, rapport, reward, cost, exploitation, voluntary, and interaction. These are the various vocabulary which you are going to cover in this video. You'll come to know about this new word, so pay attention. If I ask you, what makes your life meaningful? What will you say? What will be your answer? You ask 10 different peers. Peers mean your friends. Ask 10 different peers. Then record the responses, that means answers. Then calculate the percentage of respondents that you have given the answers, who mentioned relationship. Okay. Now, let's come to roles and relationship. Okay. Roles and relationship we are going to do here. How will you build your relationship? We are going to discuss here. how to build your relationship. A relationship can be one of the most important things in your life. So it is worthwhile to learn about them and how to make them stronger. Healthy relationship can meet personal needs, help you get things done, and enrich life. Now the fourth vocabulary here is relationship. You can see here the word relationship. It means a connection with another person. Relationship means a connection with another person. So you have seen here what is most important thing to make a healthy relationship stronger. You have to be very kind and you have to understand others. Now let's move ahead. Now build your relationship. Build your relationship is also very important, how you will build your relationships. And it depends on the types of relationship which you build. People have different types of healthy relationship with the many people they know. It is possible to have a weak but friendly relationship with an acquaintance. What does the word acquaintance mean here in the vocabulary is given? A person known to one, but usually not a close friend. That means acquaintance is that person which whom you know. Acquaintance is that person whom you know, but usually that person is not your close friend. That person is called acquaintance. So it is possible to have a weak but friendly relationship with an acquaintance. It is good to meet and interact with a variety of people. Diversity keeps things interesting. Move ahead. Now, a person chooses his or her closest friend. Those relationships are voluntary. That means what is voluntary? Voluntary mean here the meaning is given, done willingly using one's free will. So a person chooses his or her closest friends. Those relationships are voluntary. A family, on the other hand, comes with built-in relationship. That means that relationship is not voluntary. That relationship is built-in relationship when you make relationship with your family. So those bonds exist automatically. Although people have to work to keep them healthy. I hope you're understanding this chapter. Pay attention, you have to understand more. Now, how a healthy relationship, what you will do, it is very important here, what you will do to maintain a healthy relationship. Is very important here. Everyone want to make a healthy relationship. Everyone want to make relationship very stronger with anybody, with his or her mother, with friend, with teacher, with co-partner, with colleagues, with your cousin, with your relatives. Everybody want good relationship, healthy relationship. But the question is how we have to make it. So see here, no relationship is perfect. A relationship can be very fulfilling, but it can also be disappointing or even painful at times. Yes, you must have experienced this in life. A relationship is very necessary. It is very fulfilling. It helps us. But it can also be sometimes very disappointing or even painful at times. If you remember properly, you might be remembering that sometimes you have to cry for your own brother. Sometimes you have to be very disappointed and unhappy because of your sister, because of your cousin, or sometimes because of your parents also. Sometimes you have to feel disappointed. So relationships are there for us, but sometimes it is very painful at times. There are several things you can focus on to keep your relationship healthy. So what are those which you will focus to make your relationship healthy? What are those? It is mutuality. Mutuality means if anyone is loving you, that you should also love that person. If anybody is loving you, you should also love that
person.
So a healthy relationship, what is the requirement you see? No relationship is perfect. A relationship can be very fulfilling, but it can also be disappointing, as I already earlier said, or even painful at times. There are several things you can focus on to keep your relationship healthy. What are those things? Mutuality. Mutuality means depending on each other. Trust means belief and trust. Self-disclosure means you have to be very open in your relationship. Don't keep any secret. Rapport means supportive. Empathy, sympathy. Shared interest, that's when you should share interest with. So, in a relationship, you need these are the qualities: mutuality, trust, self-disclosure, rapport, empathy, and shared interest. Now, a healthy relationship. Now, slowly, slowly, one by one, we are going to see what is mutuality. Imagine that you and a classmate are working on a project together. It would not be fair if one person did all the project together. It would not be fair if one person did all the work. Relationships are the same way. They require mutuality. Mutuality means a condition in which both people in a relationship contribute to the feelings and actions that support the relationship. Let's move ahead. Now, a healthy relationship. When a close friend makes fun of you, he or she does more than hurt your feelings. That close friend also breaks the trust you felt by being his or her friend. So, trust. The belief that others will not reject betray or hurt one. A healthy relationship, people will tell another person more about themselves as the relationship between them grows stronger. Self-disclosure indicates that you feel close enough to someone to trust them with your thoughts and feelings. You must be having some of your friends with whom you share everything. When you share everything with your friend, mean you are self-disclosure. That's when you are disclosing yourself. So what is self-disclosure mean? In the vocabulary column, you can see self-disclosure means the willingness to share personal matters pertaining to oneself with others. I hope you're understanding the chapter. Now, a healthy relationship. On his or her first day at a new job, a worker often notices the good rapport between co-workers who have been in the office much longer. So what is rapport mean? In the word meaning, you can see a rapport mean a feeling of ease with another person. That means when you feel comfortable with another person, that is called rapport. So on his or her first day at a new job, a worker often notices the good rapport between co-workers who have been in the office much longer. Rapport is a healthy sign that the office functions well, even if the worker might take a while to share it. Move ahead. Now, relationship can also benefit from empathy and shared interest. So, a relationship can also benefit from empathy and shared interest. Empathy. What is empathy actually means here? People with the ability to set aside their own ideas, understand someone else's opinion. That is called empathy. And shared interest, sometimes it is easy to develop a friendship with someone who shares your interest. Now, our relationship take a lot of work. The cost of any relationship consists of the time, effort, and emotions. It's very important. The cost of any relationship consists of the time, effort, and emotions that you put into it. Sometimes that cost will also include the money you have spent for gifts or to help out a friend in need. What is cost mean? Cost mean physical, mental, and emotional contributions made to a relationship. Now let's move ahead. Relationship rewards and cost. Relationship also give you a lot in return. Some people may look for material return while others want emotional support. The main reward for a healthy relationship is often the feeling that it fulfills your own personal needs. That is what a reward. A reward is a benefit that brings pleasure and satisfaction in a relationship. Now see here, sometimes we get upset of our relationship sometimes. Relationship do not just end at the first sign of trouble. Friends and family can accidentally let you down. Maintaining a relationship means getting through the hurt or disappointment that friends and family can sometimes make you feel. So don't feel bad when anybody lets you down. Have confidence and move ahead. Danger. So, danger signals in a relationship. Sometimes we feel danger in a relationship, then how should we deal? A relationship suffers when it is not satisfying. Some relationships are not worth pursuing anymore. One key sign is when a relationship loses its mutualism, no one wants to do all the work or be the victim of exploitation. What does exploitation mean? Exploitation means the act of using a person or thing unfairly for personal benefit. So keep all these things in mind to maintain a healthy relationship. Now walk away. It can feel like defeat to end the relationship. Remember that as you change, your needs change. It is not worth the cost to maintain a relationship that no longer fulfills you. When a relationship, it costs nothing to you, it's better to end that relationship. People often find it difficult to walk away from involuntary relationships like those with relatives or co-workers. If you cannot repair these relationships, try to treat the other person like an acquaintance. Be friendly, but do not try to get close. Now, relationship with others. There can be many roadblocks to building and maintaining a variety of healthy relationships. Hunter's family moves often. Cal prefers computer games to playing with other kids. Maureen cannot seem to find relationships that are fulfilling. And Claire and her twin sister spend all of their time together and do not meet anybody else. What does this show? Skills you will need. Lots of relationships require the same set of skills. Good communication, conflict prevention, and resolution, reaching out to others. So watch how other people conduct the relationship and try to learn from your own. So I hope you have understood these key features of relationship. Identify three functions of relationship in a person's life. Relationship functions to meet your emotional needs, enrich your life, and help you get things. So always maintain a good relationship and always give importance to your relationship. So I hope you have understood this chapter on family. This was the third part, and you have understood how to maintain a relationship and what is your role in a relationship. So I hope you have understood the video and liked the video. Keep on watching my video. See you again. Goodbye.